Hello student, welcome to the physics class. Now I am going to discuss chapter 2, force and laws of motion. In previous video I have discussed about the definition of force and laws of motion. We have discussed about the first law of motion, second law of motion. In first law of motion we told you about the inertia, and we also told you about inertia is the measure of mass. After that we come to the first law of motion and second law of motion. In second law of motion we have told you about that the force F equal to ma. We proved this formula in the second law of motion. What was the second law of motion? The rate of change of momentum of any object is directly proportional to applied and balanced force. Now we get this formula by mathematical formulation of second law of motion. F equal to ma. F was the applied and balanced force. M is the mass of the object, and A was the acceleration. From which we calculate the acceleration. Acceleration, final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. So we can calculate the acceleration by this method, which I also told you in chapter 1. Now we come to the what is the unit of force? Unit of force. So unit of force in SI, what will be? F equal to ma. Here unit of mass is kg, and unit of acceleration meter. What is meter per second square? You have read it in chapter 1. So what will be the unit? Kg into meter per second square. But in 1 kg into meter per 1 kg into meter per second square equal to 1 newton. This is 1 newton. This is the SI unit. And the CGS unit, CGS, it will 1 kg will be 1 gram, meter will be centimeter, time will be seconds. It will be 1 dyne. What is the CGS unit of force in? Will be dyne. And this is 1 gram into centimeter per second square. So, after second law of motion, now I am going to discuss about the third law of motion. So, what is third law of motion? Third law of motion. Have you seen its effect on your daily life? Third law of motion. Third law of motion. Third law of motion. What is third law of motion? Third law of motion tells that every action has equal and opposite reaction. Means if we apply some force on any object, then that object other also exert the same force in the opposite direction of that. Suppose you want to push any object, then there is another force which also pushing us. That is known as action and reaction. So what is third law of motion? It says that to every action there is equal and opposite reaction. Means if you its application is so many. We want to walk on the ground, there are so many other application of third law of motion. Now next is we are going to understand about the law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. Which momentum? Linear momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. What this law says? According to this law, if there is no external force acting on the system, then the body's their initial momentum and final momentum will be conserved or constant. What this thing?
change in time.
will be delta T. And force on B will be FBA. What it will be? M2V2 minus M2U2 upon delta T. Now according to third law of motion, what will be FAB equal to minus FE? This is the equation first and this is the equation 2. Putting the value of FAB and FEB in equation number 3, what will be value of FAB will be M1V1 minus M1U1 upon delta T, and the value of FBA will be minus. Why we put the minus sign? Because there both directions are opposite. If this is plus, then this will be negative. What? Then put value M2V2 minus M2U2 upon delta T. Now the time is same for both the bodies, but then this will be cancelled out. What we will get? M1V1 minus M1U1 is equal to, this will be minus M2V2, and this will be plus M2U. Now we can write it like this: M1V1, and we take this M2V2, this side, this will become plus M2V2 equal to, this is M2U2, this will go to this side, this will become plus M1U. Now if you want to write about this like this, M1U1 plus M2U2 equal to M1V1 plus M2V2. So what is this? This is the initial momentum. Initial momentum. And this final momentum. Final momentum. So we can see that law of conservation is applied here. Initial momentum equal to final momentum. Then this is the law of conservation of momentum. Now we learn what is the application of conservation of momentum. There are application of conservation of momentum in two ways. Recoiling of gun. Have you ever seen about gun? When it fire, if fire right, it recoils in the backward side. Then this is the application of law of conservation. In your book, you see the most type of question in on this. Then you can try this, practice this, and if you got any problem, then you can contact me. So this is the chapter 2, force and law of motion chapter. Portion I have covered, and rest of portion we will later. When it will be, if this is there is buoyancy and